I was a failure. I was a failure, and I get very sad and depressed about it, and I can't be that no more. I really feel like I've betrayed myself big time. Because I think when I was growing up, I had all the potential in the world. Now I'm back to being Mark, who has a beer in his hand and is thinking about the great American script and the great American movie. And this time I cannot fail. I won't fail. It's not in me. You don't get second chances and mess them up. You'd be a fool to. Not just finishing films or in the long run getting some money, but it's right now. I feel like it's, like I said, 5, 10, 15 years ago. Now I've got the same options again, and this time I'm not going to fail. This time it's most important not to fail, just to drink and dream, but rather to create and complete.
Hey man, you have 2 hours tomorrow from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. and be an extra in a film?
You stupid fucking bitch! This is 186 fucking minute phone call!
Who the hell in their right mind would tell the world, yeah, I'm gonna do this, and then think, man, where am I going? I'm broke, man. I gotta get gas tomorrow. And dude's talking about making a feature film. Shit.
So you gotta get a cameraman. You gotta get a sound recorder, a boom operator, an assistant cameraman to do the clap like that.
Well, we gotta make like a line where people can't go. Have a hell of a lot of assistant directors saying, hey, could you step back like 5 feet?
You're gonna fucking spend your whole life around surrounded by people. We're gonna do this and we're gonna do that and we're gonna do that. What do you think? What do you fucking really think, huh?
Coven's a 35-minute direct market thriller film shot on 16mm black and white reversal.
He asked me to come over and help him out. He said he needs some help. I'm always helping him with his films.
It's the first line of the film, man. It's got to be on the money here.
It's all right. It's okay. There's something to live for. Jesus told me so.
You have to believe in what you're saying, Bill.
Well, I don't.
This whole thing has turned into a theatrical mockery. You understand that, Mike?
No.
Well, you will.
It's about 11:30 in the morning. We got till 6 p.m. to do 52 fucking shots, and we're going to do it, and we're going to end it in a beautiful fucking bloodbath.
Shot 37 here while my head goes through the cupboard.
Motherfucker! No, man!
You know, we're in America today and we're ready to roll.
That was wicked, man.
He lives for movies, making movies. Always dreaming that someday, you know, he will make a big movie.
I've, for years, man, I've been trying to face up to who I am and shit like that, but I can't. I don't know why, man. It's like I know where I want to be and what I want to do, and so I don't know how I'm going to come out of all of this stuff.
I don't see how people can go year after year at these fucking stupid jobs and not want to make something of themselves.
With Northwestern, he's putting the more of the drama into it. Obviously, this is not a horror film. This is a more of a life and times. Probably going to use a lot of his own experience, you know, as far as what he went through in life.
The earth decays and the cars have decayed and these guys are decaying, you know? And that's what it's all about, you know? It's that's what it's all about, rust and decay. But then within that is the warmth of the soul and stuff like that.
Every time I spoke with him and every time we got together, there was something that seemed to go wrong.
Oh, dude.
And he always seemed to forge ahead and go through with the project. And I think that's the best thing that I can say about his character. He's indomitable.
We get to see Americans and American dreams, and you won't walk away depressed after seeing this.
I was reading an interview of him, and he's going, oh, this is my dream. Since I was a little kid filming in a cemetery, I've dreamt of making a feature film. This is his whole life, is making this one film.
This has been going on now, literally, for 3 years. But through all of this, Mark has kept an equanimity.
When I hear the projector rolling and I see Kevin on the screen,
yeah.
Totally, you know?
All the time.
Yeah!
Well, I hope all the best for Mark. He works hard, and he has a lot of dreams.
Here, we're living it, and I will be goddamned if I don't get the American dream.
And you know what? I'm going to bring over a bottle of wine, man. You have a preference?
Have a beautiful day.
Red or white wine? Red or white?
Red or white.
Yeah, now you're thinking.
The American dream stays with me each and every day, and I'm glad we're doing this today because I was really getting down and out, and thank God they extended my phone bill till Friday and lowered it too. But anyway, so today, man, I'm just gonna go right back to work, man, so we can get, actually my house ain't gonna look like this, man. It's gonna be flatter, a lot flatter, less obnoxious than this.